Dog Arnian Argus, oh, that's beautiful. Public house dining pala. Public house dining. Umbrella Ania, Mercia. Mercia is
Glasgow.
Oh, nga no. Mula na ba? Kaya pala ko nagtatakbo, sinave mo na yung sarili mo. Ako walang problema, I got umbrella.
Coming up on your left hand side, this strange shaped looking building is a Ministry of Defence building, and it holds all the personal records of all the servicemen serving in the British Armed Forces. It's called Kentigan House, and Kentigan is another name for Glasgow's patron saint, St.
That is beautiful.
Up ahead of us is the M8 motorway. It's 60 miles long and 97 kilometres. It goes from Greenock in the west all the way through to Edinburgh in the east. It's one of the busiest motorways here in the UK. And this section we're about to go under is the off-ramp onto the Kingston Bridge, one of the busiest river crossings in Europe, opened in 1970 by the Queen Mother and named after the Kingston dock that used to sit on the south side of the river. Straight ahead of us, you see another mural. This is called Swimmers and Divers, and this was commissioned by Glasgow City Council for the 2014 Commonwealth Games. It was completed by the Australian artist Sam Bates, who done it. If you saw the mural at number two of St Mungo, it's the same artist. Also, this section of the waterfront is called the Broomie Law. Back up to the 1970s, this is where Glaswegians would take the annual two-week holiday or the day trip, particularly at the Glasgow Fair. The Glasgow Fair is a holiday here in Glasgow. It's the last 2 weeks in July. It was gifted to the city as far back as the 12th century. But up to the 70s, all the shipyards, dockyards, steelworks, foundries and offices would close for those 2 weeks in July, and thousands of people would be lined along the front here to take the wee Clyde Puffer or steamer boats, as we say in Glasgow, for a wee trip down the water, or in proper English, a small trip down the water to various holiday locations like the Noon, Rosset and Largs. And if you look at the River Clyde now here to the left, she's a lot quieter than what she used to be. She would have had ships docked at both sides, sailing to almost everywhere and anywhere in the world. And this is where a lot of Scottish immigrants left for America, Canada, and Australia from the river. Along the banks here of river. And coming up past the flats, which were warehouses in the bay, you still see reminders of where the ships used to dock. Also past the flats is a new bridge across the Clyde. It was opened in 2006. It is called the Clyde Arc. If you ask the Glaswegian where the Clyde Arc is, they'll probably just give you a blank stare, because we don't know it by that name in the city. We only know it by its nickname, and that's the Squinty Bridge, because it crosses the Clyde at a wee bit of an angle, and it's coming up on your left hand side. So the next stop coming up is stop number 10, also for stop number 11, and that's for the Crown Plaza Hotel, Clyde Auditorium, the Hilton Garden Inn Hotel, Radisson Red Hotel, the SSE Hydro, and the side centre view of the Blue Bells Bridge. So the next stop is stop number 10, stop number 11. So coming into view, you see where the ships used to dock, both sides of the river. On your left, on the south side, you see a red hotel, garden here to your left. Garden is the South Rotunda. Hilton Garden Hotel. This is the North Rotunda. These date from the
Oh yeah, I remember this one.
And this is the entrance to the first Clyde Tunnel. Underneath the River Clyde, here's three passageways. One was each way for horses and carriages, and one was for pedestrians. The vehicle section shut in the 1940s. Pedestrian section shut in 1980. Rotunda here on your left on the south side has been taken over by an engineering company. And this side of the river, Greenside, this is now restaurants and